learn about a new framework called Cucumber. So what is Cucumber? What on all Cucumber? So Cucumber is very interesting and very easiest comparing to your just ng. Cucumber is very easy. Now the first thing why we need Cucumber is basically it is like for example, let's say that we are going to get a new what do we call that, a new feature from our client. Then mostly when we are going to work in the agile, they don't maintain that much documentation, actually zero documentation. I can say that in most of the companies they do not prefer to do the documentations, but of course they have some sort of requirements, so that we'll talk. So what happens in the industry, so whenever I say something, that should be reflected in the pictorial representation. So that is what the BDD stands for. BDD means behavior driven development. Okay, so when I say something, you should observe, like, okay, this is what actually going to happen. For example, let's say that I want to go to ATM. Okay, so in the ATM, first thing what I have to check is, of course, I should have the card and I should remember the PIN, right? So in terms of Cucumber, I can say that when I go to ATM, right? So when is here a keyword? We'll talk about the keywords in later. So when I go to ATM, I must have ATM card as well as the ATM PIN. And after that, what we need, we have to swipe in the card. Once we do that, of course, we have to make sure that we have balance. If there is balance, of course, what are the amount we are going to give, we are able to withdraw, right? So the process is very simple. The process is like you have to go to ATM machine and you have to swipe in your card and you have to get the cash, right? Now, this thing, so whatever the things I have, what are the steps I have said now, that should be reflected to the developers as well as the testers, right? For example, when I say the same to the developers, developers should understand in a way that how they are going to implement that. And the same requirement when I come and say to the tester, tester should know like how they are going to test the whatever the code we have in our dev site, in the dev environment, how we are going to do the testing for that. So that is why. So that is how the BDD comes into the picture. Before the BDD, we have something called TDD, that is test-driven development. So the disadvantage of TDD is when we follow the test-driven development, what happens is we mostly focus in terms of testing. So as a testers, we always used to try to find bug, right? So we do not worry about the positive scenarios. As soon as we are going to start something, we are more focused on the negative thing, right? So that's a bad practice. Don't do that first. Whenever a build comes, first do the positive and tell the, if it's going to be new feature, means give some feedback to the developers and then go with the negative test case. Just if you go and first itself, if you give the negative test case, of course there will be it's not a good way of doing the testing. So I personally follow that. Even if you think that's worth, I can say that you can also follow, okay? Now, when I say that BDD means, I said that it is going to be whatever I say to you, it should be a pictorial representation, right? For example, let me say that if I'm taking to a forest, okay, if I'm taking to a forest and I tie your eyes, and if I ask you to just touch an object, okay, so you don't know what is the object. So you guys are in a gang, you are maybe 5 or 10 people are there, you are touching the same object. But the object has different things, and each one of you are going to touch something, right? So for example, let's say take an elephant. So there is an elephant you guys are touching. So someone is touching the trunk, they will think different. Someone touching the legs, they will think different. Someone touching the tail, they are of course going to think as a different object, right? But the whole entity is only one. So in terms of business perspective, whatever the functions or whatever the scenarios we are going to get, we should follow the same scenario in terms of development as well as testing. Now, when we are going to test an application, of course, we have to get the requirements from the client side, right? Of course, we are not going to get from the client directly. Of course, there will be a person called business analyst, right? BA. So the business analyst is going to interact with the client and as well as the developer and as well as the tester. So client knows that, okay, what is the thing we want? So client will try to explain the thing to the business analyst, and business analyst is going to give the resources to the developers as well as the tester. So when we are going to test something, of course we should know the functionality. So how do we know the functionality? If I say like, okay, go and check the, okay, let me give you an example. If I ask you to just go and test this application here, what will you test first? This Amazon.in, okay, I'm just giving to you and I'm asking you to test this application. What are the things you will do first?
First thing, I will check the URL that, okay, we are on the correct URL.
Okay.
And then the, like, you know, title this Amazon, the logo and all, that it is of Amazon and as expected.
Okay.
And then we have the search box getting appeared on the home page, and then all the categories, everything, and you know, in the menu bar we have all the other options like sign in, sign out, address, orders, all those options, like which we generally use.
Okay, so these are the things, right? So someone has any other answers?
UI means whatever features are there in the UI, whether it's working properly or not.
Okay, so we mostly do the UI check, we do the UI checks, like if the link is working, the logo is appearing there, the URL is working there, right? But as a client, my intention is not to check the UI. I just want to know that my application is up and running. That means I should get the 200 as my status code, right? So whatever I said now and whatever you guys said now is entirely different, right? So this is why the BDD comes into the picture. So as a client, what I want to get, I know that the BA, business analyst, and business analyst is going to give us the task, right? So this is why the BDD is very important. So when I say like, if I just say like, let's say that there is a new business requirement and the requirement is something like, they just want to create a form here, and this form needs two text box and a login button and a forget password link here, right? So this is the business requirement. Now, this can be designed in different ways, right? So this, I just draw a box. It can be full layer page, or it can be just section of the page, and so many things are possible. We cannot judge like how the UI is going to appear. But instead of that, if the client says that, okay, this is the UI, this is what I want to see in my screen, means of course developers are going to test, build that. Now, as a tester, what we do is whatever the flows we have to make sure that, okay, we are following the same step, right? Because the requirement will say like, okay, you should have a user box, username text box, password text box, and followed by login. So what we are going to do is we are going to automate that particular page where we have this username. So when writing, we should not change the flow, right? So my flow here is only to do the positive testing. So at that particular point, what I will do is I will first go to the application, then I will enter the username, enter the password, and click on the login, right? So that is how we have to do the testing. Now, the steps or the business requirements are given by the BDD. Business analyst. So BDD plays a major role where whatever we get the requirement from the client, that should go exactly to the developers as well as tester. Okay, so that is what BD actually stands for, but industry, no one follows the same. But by definition, this is what BDD, and this is how they used to define what is the purpose of BDD. But trust me, no one follows the same in most of the cases that we force. So I cannot say that BDD also perfect. By definition, it is perfect, but people don't follow that. That is the truth of this. Okay, now, I said that whenever there is a requirement, it should go to the developer and the testers exactly same, right? So how we are going to write that? Because of course we have to give some, because if I say in verbally, of course it's not going to work, right? So because, have you seen that video? If I remember that, I don't know that link. So there is some communication videos is there, like communication English practices, where what people do is like, they will ask you to do one thing and you have to do the same thing to the next person, and it will go like for 10-20 people, and at the end the entire whatever the first person says is going to differ, right? Have you seen that video? I don't know if I can take that correctly.
I was actually not able to understand what you were referring to.
Video or the...
The video, actually.
Video, okay. That is what I'm searching for. I just forgot that. Not this one. Okay, I just forgot. Maybe in the break I'll search that. So, okay, that's called the game of telephone. Can I search that in YouTube? Okay, anyways.
You are talking about the game like in a chain, people will stand and one will whisper something in one's ear
and then you're
passing it.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so what was your question?
No, not question. I'm just saying like when one person says one information to the another person, the same thing doesn't travel, right? So the same communication doesn't happen. It gets changed, right?
Yes.
At some point, it gets changed.
Some people, the very next person whom with I'm communicating to interprets it in a different way. And in this way, it actually reaches the end point in a totally different note. That is what you're saying.
Yeah, that is what I'm actually trying. So I just thought of showing you that video. I got that video from somewhere. I forgot the link. So I will take that link in the break, okay? So that is what the ability comes into the picture. So whatever we are going to say to someone, so that should be exactly followed by others as well, right? Now, this is what summarized of a BDD. Of course, you can go to the documents. There are very more theoretical on this. So I'm not going to cover the theoretical part more. So we'll see the coding. Now, this communication happens in terms of some of the keywords. So that keywords, of course, is another language. So today we are going to learn one more language called Jerkin. So Jerkin, so this guy, right? Jerkin. So Jerkin is the language that is followed by the Cucumber. Now, Cucumber is not only for testing. Please remember, Cucumber is not a testing. Some of the people think that Cucumber is only for Selenium testing purpose. That's not true. Cucumber can do anything if it just need. It is just like documentation. Okay. So for example, here you can see it can run in JavaScript, in Ruby, in Lua. I don't know what is that. In CPP, Android, Kotlin, J, PHP. So everything, each and every program language has this Cucumber support, most of the program language. And Cucumber follows the language called Jerkin. So this is what this Jerkin language. So it has very few keywords. So you can head out to this reference documentation for your learning, okay? So this keyword has only few keywords like given, when, then, and but. Okay, so these are the five keywords mostly used in terms of what we call that, in terms of writing a documentation. Okay, so we are going to write a documentation today using the Cucumber Jerkin. So that is known as feature file. So this Jerkin language, using this we are going to write the feature file. So feature file is going to act as like your documentation. I said that in Agile, most of the time people do not follow the Agile. I mean, do not follow the documentations. They rather used to follow this feature file. Okay, so that is what similar to your documentation. Okay, but feature file will be mostly written by the business as analyst. So in my project, we are using this BA in not this project, in my previous project, there we have a BA who used to write the feature file for us, and we used to automate that. Okay. But nowadays, in most of the companies, they are not allocating BA, business analyst will be there, but they are not allocating them to write the feature file. Rather, they are asking testers, QA, to write the feature file as well. Okay, so it is a good to know that how we have to write the documentation efficiently. But of course, I'm just going to teach you the basic. In every organization, they have their own rule set. So do not worry about this. Just try to learn these keywords. That is pretty much enough. You can, of course, learn in your organization as well. Okay. So first thing, we have to First of all, are you able to understand why BDD is important? To be simple, just to make sure the business requirement, whatever we are going to get from our client, that should not be changed. Of course, it happens in most of the time, Komal said, like in previous class, that after 90% completion of the project also, it gets changed, right? That happens, but just really make sure that that doesn't happen for a while, at least the functionality of the any application. Okay, any doubt?
No questions.
Okay. So I'm sending the dependency in the chat. So take that and add in your pom.xml, and that's it. So this is the reason we are using page object model, or else what I have to do is I have to go to the Maven repository and I have to download the jar file manually. And again, I have to add to the build, right? So instead of that, I can just say here, and it is going to download and store in our local machine so that we can use in our projects, okay? So just copy, paste, save, and that's it. So if you are using antivirus, please disable as of now. And then we have to use another plugin here. So for TestNG, we are using this TestNG plugin, right? So for Cucumber also, we have to use another plugin that is known as Natural Editor. That is not mandatory. Even without that also, we can run. But to highlight the syntax, we are going to use that Natural plugin. Okay, so Natural Editor. So just go to Help and click on this Eclipse Marketplace. And I think I already have. Let me check. Okay, and just type in the search box as natural editor or natural. Yeah, so this one, so natural 0.9 is already installed in my system. So you have to just click on install and then restart your Eclipse. So that's it. Okay. So you have to search for this natural. Just type natural, it will come in the first place, I think. Or else you can type natural space 0.9. Okay. So let's continue with this. So I'm just going to open. Okay. So how the Cucumber project structure is defined is like mostly it is written within the SRC test folder because it is considered as only for testing, not for development, for us, for in the QA I'm talking about. So we are going to write everything in the SRC test Java, and that is what the Cucumber docs also suggest to use the SRC test. Again, just maintainability, but we are going to follow the same standard. Okay. And within that, we are going to have, yes?
Sorry to interrupt you, but while installing natural, do we need to select the JBehave editor as well, or we just need to download Cucumber editor?
Just download the Cucumber editor. JBehave is not needed.
Okay.
So JBehave is actually another similar to BDD. We have this JBehave as well. Okay. So Cucumber supports almost all programming languages like JavaScript, Java, Ruby, CPP, Kotlin, everything. But whereas I think C Sharp supports only spec flow. There is something called spec flow that is only available for C Sharp. Okay, so that's And similar to Cucumber, we have also JBehave, and another one is getting very famous nowadays is what was that? It's also start from S. I forgot that name. Okay, I'll tell you. Okay, so mostly most of the industry follows Cucumber. Cucumber, other than Cucumber, what people mostly use, if it's C Sharp project, they are going to use only the spec flow. They do not have any other options. But for Java, we have also one more guy that is also becoming very famous now. So let's here we have the Selenium AspecJS, not this guys. Just a second, guys. I forgot that name. So similar to JBehave, we have JDev, and Concordian, Witnessy, TestLive, SpecFlow. Not this guy, actually. I'm looking for something else. Okay, anyways, we'll see. Okay. Okay, so how the folder structure is going to be like? First, we have to maintain the feature file. So this is going to be a feature file. So this is nothing but your docs, your like steps to follow. Okay. And then after that, we are going to make a folder called steps. So steps or step definition. So step definition. Let me write that. Okay. Step definition is like whatever the document we are going to write here, we are going to map that in terms of Java. Okay. So we are going to use this for our Java coding. Okay. And after that, we are going to use a runner file. So runner file in the sense, this guy is like your execution file. Like in TestNG, we have this XML, right? So similarly in Cucumber, we have this runner file. Okay. So we are going to create all those threes, and Cucumber is very, very easy. Don't get very tough. It's going to be very easy. Just, you have to understand the keywords. That's it. Okay. Are you clear with this project structure as of now? Okay. Okay, so I'm not going to create another new project. I'm just going to create, I'm going to use the same existing project. So within the SRC test, I'm going to create three folder first. So first one, of course, the feature. So F-E-A-T-E-R-E features. Feature or feature. And then followed by, we are going to have a steps. So steps definition, let me add this definition. And then we are going to create another folder. So that's going to be your runner folder, right? So runner. Okay. Now within the feature folder, I'm going to create a feature file first. So that is going to be a documentation. So right click new and click on this other and click on file. And just select this within the general tab, click on this file. Okay. Just write the steps. Don't do along with me. I will give you time. Okay. And here we are going to just click on next. And here I'm going to say, so we are going to just, I'm just going to write the login functionality. So I will say login dot feature F-E-A-T-U-R-E. Okay. So once I hit enter, now this is going to store in the file format of dot feature. Like whatever the code we are going to write in Java file, that's going to be our dot Java, right? Similarly, for the understand of the Jerkin language, we are going to use this dot feature file with the extension. Now, as soon as I say here you can see, right, we are getting some Cucumber icon, right? That's because of that plugin, natural editor plugin. If you don't have that plugin, this is not going to come. It will look just like a flat file. Flat file in the sense, just a file. Okay, so any file is known as flat file. Okay, so this is why we are using this Jerkin. The natural editor. Now the best part of Jerkin, the natural editor is whenever I'm going to type something like this, it is going to give us auto suggestions. It should give auto suggestions. Yeah, so it is going to give us auto suggestions like we are getting in our Java code, right? So same thing, that is the only purpose. Even without the natural editor, of course you can run. So that's not a problem, okay? So first we are going to write the feature file. So first thing you have to remember is feature file always starts with the keyword called feature. So here if I say feature, so this is how your documentation should look. Now feature in the sense what we are going to do, right? So for example, let's say that, let's take this application, Mercury. Okay, so this guy, right? So this guy, this is our feature file. In the feature file, we are going to write the test case related to this application, right? So here my feature is going to be automate this particular website, right? So I can just give some name like that. So here I can say AUT application under test, and here I can say Mercury, right? So this is going to be your feature file. That's it. Just a name. We are giving just a name to this. After the feature file, what we have to write is scenarios, right? So scenarios. Now scenario means what?
Test scenario or whatever we have to validate.
Yeah, exactly. That's it, right? So for example, this entire application is my feature file, feature. But in this application, I have positive test case, I have negative test case, I have login test case, I have registered test case, I have support, I have contact, different modules, right? So each and every modules are known as scenario. Okay. Now there are two things. One is the scenario and another one is the scenario outline. I will tell you the differences. Okay. So here I'm going to say login. You can write anything. It is not necessary. You have to follow like a camel case or underscore, nothing like that. It is just your documentation, like a text notepad file or a text file or a Word file. Okay. So here I'm going to say login positive maybe. So we are just going to automate the positive login scenario, right? Now, after this scenario, we have to say what are the steps we have to follow, right? So in terms of automating this, what are the things we will do? Tell me from the very first step.
We'll open the browser, enter that particular link, enter username, password, and then check for the button, login button, click that, and check if we are able to actually click on that button and land on next page.
Right. Now, these are the conditions. In these conditions, when your actual test case is starting?
We have to be on that particular page.
Right.
Being on the particular page or...
When the URL is loaded, when we start to enter the username, that's when our...
Okay, so we have to be on that page so that we can enter the username, password and check on the corresponding.
So basically login positive in the sense the test case should start when I'm going to enter the username, right?
Yes.
So that's one. So before that, of course, we have to launch our browser. We have to maximize our browser. We have to set the timeout and we have to load the URL. So that will comes in the preconditions, right?
Yes.
Now, when I say that I have to enter the username, that's where we are going to start the test case, right? So we are going to see how to convert the same scenario in terms of jerk-in, okay? So first thing, it always starts with the given keyword. Now given in the sense, it's going to be like your precondition, okay? Here I'm going to say given, launch the browser. And then again, if I say given and maximize, and then again given, load URL. And then again, given what we set, set timeout. Okay. Now, if I give this document to you, it's look okay. It's look okay. So it's like given launch the browser, given maximize the browser, given load the URL, given set timeout. Now we can write like this because this everything are preconditions to my actual test case. But we should not do the same repetitive like again and again, right? Because if I give to someone and if I ask them to read like given, 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 they will get irritated, right? Irritated in the sense like this doesn't look any good to me, right? So what we can do is we can use the another keyword called and here. So and is nothing but your supporting conditions. So instead of saying like given, given everywhere, I can say like given, launch the browser and maximize the browser and load the URL and set the timeout. So which one looks good now? This one or the previous one?
With and condition, this one.
And condition, right? So that is why what the use of this and condition. Given is your preconditions. Of course, we can write all the steps in the precondition using the given keywords, but that doesn't look good. So we are using this supporting condition, which is that is and here, right? And after that, here actual things is coming, right? I have to enter the username. So that's where my test case actually starts, right? So here I'm going to say when I enter, when user, I or user anything. So user enter the username. Okay. And again, here I can also write like when user enter the password, right? And again, I can say when user clicks on the login button, right? Here I can say like this, but again, this doesn't look good to me. So what we can do is we can change the actions using the and keyword. That is what the usage of and here, right? So similar to our, this guy, who is this? This condition, given condition, we are using this, right? So same thing, we can use this keyword anywhere. Now, these are just for our understanding. Even if you write given, when, or the and condition like shuffled, even if you shuffled, that's going to work for sure. That doesn't matter. But the thing here is when I give this documentation to any other person, they should also understand what we are going to do, right? So mostly when in the sense like, it's like here actually your test case starts and they will understand, okay, these are the following steps I have to follow after the test case starts. And now here we have to say what happens when we do the login, right? So this is where we are expecting our outcomes, right? So that time we have to use this keyword as then, okay? Then we'll say logged in success, right? So we'll do some validation and we'll say like login success. Login should success, right? So this is how we have to use this given and when and then, okay? So given is like your preconditions and is like your supporting conditions to any of the keywords. And when is like when we are going to start our actual test case, and then is used if the test scenario is going to be positive and this is what the final output, this is what we are expecting from our test case, right? Now let's say that I have another scenario here, so I'm just going to copy this and I'm going to paste over here, and it is going to be of negative, okay? So here I'm going to check for negative. Okay, at this point, what will happen means when these are my preconditions, everything is fine, not a problem. But here all my test case is starting, that's also not a problem. But here, and user click on the login button, then what should happen?
Login should fail.
Login should fail, right? Yeah. So here, when the test scenario is going to be negative, you should not use the then keyword here. You should use this but keyword here. So but keyword stands for your negative testing, okay? So these are the only 5 keywords we mostly used when writing our jerkin feature file, okay? So the key points you have to remember is always it should start with the future. And if you notice carefully, here the future has the colon, right? So for the future and scenario, we will get this colon, and other keywords, we do not get anything, okay? So this is how we have to write our feature file. So I'm just going to comment this guy as of now. And to format this file, you have to right click and go to the source and click on format, okay? So this will give you format, okay? So this is the keywords available in what we call this, in this jerkin language. Other than that, we have some other keywords as well. So we'll talk about this one by one, so do not worry. So it is going to be very, very easy. So I'm just going to cover everything like background, scenario, outline, examples, this example same. This rule is, I don't know actually. So this is released in the version of 6. I think this is just released now. So I'm not sure about it yet. So I'm not going to cover this. Other than that, these are the keywords. If you know this, that means you know 100% cucumber. And this rule you can learn afterwards as well. So I don't think, okay, they have documentation. Maybe I'll check and let you know maybe next week, okay? So this new feature, which is introduced in the version 6. So we are not going to cover this, but of course we are going to cover everything here, okay? So any doubt on this, how to write a document file?
Kaushik, can you please tell again, like how you created that login feature?
Okay, just create a folder called feature, and within this,
let me write it. Okay, new.
And new, and click on this other.
So are we actually creating the test scenarios here? I'm not clear with that part. What
yes,
exactly
we are creating only the test scenarios, like documentation.
This is only the documentation, nothing
yes.
else, right?
Nothing else. Like when we do the manual testing, we'll get an Excel sheet, right? So when we are going to work in the Agile, mostly we'll get documentation in terms of feature file.
This is the standard format to write the feature file.
Yes. Okay, so in this pop-up, just type file and click on the file and click on next. And then just give any name and then followed by dot feature extension. That's it.
Okay.
So we are just writing the documentation. Of course, I cannot run this, right? So if I do right click run as, of course, I'm not able to get any Java application or anything. So of course, that's not going to work for sure. So we know that Selenium can interact with the Java, not with the jerkin language, right? So of course, we have to write the steps now, okay? So before that, if you have any questions regarding this keywords, you can ask me.
Kaushik, like after this given keyword, in our scenario, like in our feature file, can we write then and after then, like when then again?
Yeah, you can write that. That doesn't matter. You can write anything as well. The only thing is the scenario should not affect your keywords. I mean that when I say like when means this is going to be like your starting point of test case, and then is like your conditional checking. We are expecting a positive, right? So that things only you should remember. Other than that, this and a given can be anything.
Okay, because we are already using, you know, feature file for our regression in the organization.
Okay.
And there, like, it was, you know, all setup was done by the developer, and they just gave us that feature file, where we just change our scenario and upload it to the portal. So there, how we write it, like, first the scenario, and then given, and for given we give the condition, then again we use then instead of like using when condition. We use then, and there we, you know, write our, you know, SOAP, XML, whatever, like our request is there. And then for when condition, we have, you know, predefined, you know, one sentence like, okay, where that should hit. And in then we are giving the condition like, yes, no, it is, you know, getting passed or failed. So I'm just curious to know that.
That depends on the application. So in this example, this is the correct one. So in your example, when you use this first given, and then you, when we go to this when or then something is, that depends on the application. For example, once we just load the URL, it is going to give us some authentication pop-up means. So then I can say like given, and then I have to handle those like that.
Okay.
It depends on the scenarios. It is not specific to this.
Yeah, but these are the basic keywords which can be like changed as per the condition. The sequence can change.
Sequence can change anytime, anywhere.
Okay.
Okay.
So what if the scenario when there is not, there are options like this or this should happen?
This or that should happen means again it's like positive negative only. So in terms of jerking, there is only two to check, the positive and the negative. Then is the positive, but is the negative.
So something like if like for example, if it is a search field, you know, and we are allowed to enter numeric values, or search should happen on the basis of either numeric or alphabets only, like not on the basis of characters. So it is a or there, like. So it is possible to get the results, but only when we are using either alphabets or digits only. So if we want to write something like that.
So when user enters alphabets or digits, then
we can write it normally in an English sentence.
Yeah. So then user should get the result. When user enters special character, then search should not come. Okay, so here we
can
do
use
not
and
use
and or in between normal English sentence as well, right? It is not like it will be treated as a keyword.
No, that and you can use or, you cannot use. So if I write like this or here, it is going to throw me exception. So that's not like, it's just not, it looks like a normal English, but it is not a normal English. These are the keywords in the jerking language. Okay. The documentation should be simple English, so don't write like complicated words. It should be very simple so that everyone can understand. But these are the keywords as you are saying, like or and that. So no.
Well, would it work if you had an and statement? You know, given the user entered alphabet or numeric.
Okay.
So then login should be successful, or search would be successful, something like that.
Yeah, you can just write something like this. So when user enter character or integer, then search result should come, right? So it's result, and when again it's like again you are checking for another condition. So when user enter special character. So if it's going to be your positive, then you can use the then. search should not appear like that, or you are going to check for the negative means, you can use the keyword called but. Are you able to get it?
Yeah, just means like but will be used only for negative, right?
Only for negative.
Okay.
Now this search is purely based upon the website, right? So when I say like special character, I have to enter the special character. So then again, it's going to be like your test scenario or your application flow. So some of the applications should allow, some of the applications should not allow. So again, that's going to be your like positive, negative. That's your application. You should know better, right? Okay, so this is very easy, guys. Just a keyword. You can of course check the documentation as well, so you'll get more idea like how to write precisely. But these are the only 5 keywords we used most of the time, and if you know this, perfectly fine for the interview and as well as the work. Okay, and next thing, of course, we cannot run this because this is our feature file, not our Java coding part. So we are going to convert this file, this document file, into the working prototype. Okay. So for that, we have this folder called step definitions. Within the step definitions, we are going to run. Now, is that mandatory? Do I have to name this as step definition? No, it is not mandatory, but these are the key points given by the Cucumber documentation. I mean, Cucumber people say that, okay, this is how you have to follow so that we can maintain the standard across everyone, right? Across the entire project or the entire organization or the entire community. So we are going to follow the same one. So some people like to write in step definitions, or some people suggest steps. So both are fine, just a folder name, but of course we have to follow based on the Cucumber standards, okay? So now we are going to write an actual class file. So here I'm going to click class, and here I'm going to say login, and that's it. So login.java. Now, first thing, we should not have main method. We should not have add test. We should not have any runnable component in this. I mean, runnable in the sense execution frameworks. Okay. The class should be very simple class, and it should have only methods. Now, how we are going to write this is, so whatever the this guy. So if I mouse over on here, you can see, right? It says that no definition found for launch the browser. That means it says that, hey, Kaushik, you have written the steps, but you didn't say how the steps should react. Okay, so that is what we are going to do here. So first thing first, of course, we need a driver. So I'm just going to create a Chrome driver. Just stop me in case you are not getting it. I'm just quickly going to write few methods here. Okay, so here public just void, and what is the method here? We are going to launch the browser, right? So I'm just going to say open browser. And then here driver equal to new driver. That's it. Now after that, again we have this method called maximize the browser. So I'm just going to write another step. So if you have 150 test cases, what will you do?
I didn't get your question, Kaushik.
I'm writing each and every steps in each and every functions, right? Mm-hmm. This is how we have to write our Cucumber test cases, test script here. So whatever the files, whatever the steps here we have here, we have to convert all those into this methods. So one step is going to be one method here, okay? For example, if I go to this feature file, as of now I have written two things and I didn't write anything, right? So even if I mouse over on this here, you can see it says that no step definition found, because my Java file doesn't know that I have a future file and how I'm going to communicate with that, right? So we are going to build the relationship now. Now this is known as technically mapping. We are going to map the future file to our test script. Okay. So before that, I'm just quickly going to write this driver.manage.window.maximize. Okay, so here I have a step to open the browser, and here I have a step to maximize the browser, right? But if I go to my feature file, again it's saying that no step definition found. So we are going to build the relationship, we are going to do the mapping here. Okay, so for that, what we have to do is we have to just copy the step. Even if you have some spaces there, that's not going to work. So make sure that you are copying the exact thing, so don't give some spaces at the end. Just copy this and go to your Java file. And on top of each and every method, here you have to say at given. So there we use this given, right? So we are going to use this given annotation here. And within this, we have to paste this guy, right? Now, if I go back and just save the file again, just do some modification and save. And now you can see, right, we didn't get this warning says that no step definition found. Now, again, I'm going to copy this. And here I'm going to make this as, so what is the annotation we used? And, right? So here I'm going to say and. And here I'm going to paste that, right? Now, once I paste this, of course, it is not going to get reflected here because this is not your Java file, right? So when we do this control S, Java compiler will say like, okay, I'm going to compile everything and it is going to give us fresh format. But when I write like this, it is not going to do the auto check for us because this is not Java file. So what we can do is we can close this file and again, we can open this file. So now here we can see, let me just give some space and save. So once I do some edit and save the file, here you can see, right? So this two guys are not getting any warning. Other than that, every guy is getting warning. So are you able to understand how we have to do the mapping?
Yes.
Now my question is,
if we use given in each of the sentences in our feature file, instead of and, we'll be using at the rate given, you know,
everywhere. Yeah.
So whatever keyword we have mentioned in the feature, we need to map it with the exact one.
Yes, exact one. But that is not mandatory. I will tell you like what happens internally. Okay. So now my question is, in case if I have this like 150 test steps, what I'm supposed to do?
Okay. For each of them, we will have to write a method.
150 method, can I write that?
No, it will be painful. Yeah.
Right. So for that, we have a shortcut in Cucumber. So we're going to follow that. Okay. I just want to show you the traditional way how we have to do the mapping. But of course, we are not going to use the same way. I cannot create this many methods in my classes. So we have a different approach. For that, we are going to create a runner file now. Okay. So within this runner package, I'm going to create a file called runner, not interface class. And here I'm going to say, maybe we'll call this as Cucumber Runner. Okay, so again, it's a class file, so Cucumber Runner. Okay, now within this class file, what we are going to write is nothing. We are not going to write anything. We are just going to extend this class to Cucumber Runnable class. That's going to be abstract, if I remember correctly. Abstract testing Cucumber test. Okay, so this is the class name where we have to extend our class file. Don't extend any other file, just extend this your runner class. Now if I right click and run as, here you can see we are able to get this run as testng, right? So that is the use of this class to be extend. Why we are doing this is within this class, within this abstract testng Cucumber test class, they have already written how the future file and our Java code is going to get combined and how it's going to extend. So we no need to worry about the internal implementation. Just we have to extend our class to this class so that it will able to execute our code, right? That's it. But if I try to run this, how do I know that this feature file is referring to this Java class file? Right, because I can have multiple class file, I can have multiple feature file, I can have multiple step definition, but somehow I have to say like, where is my feature file and everything, right? So for that, here on top of this class, we are going to use another annotations called at Cucumber option. So here I have to say at Cucumber option. Okay, so this is the one. Please remember, you should always import this from cucumber.api. Sometimes it shows suggestions from cucumber.io, I think. So that is the older version. That is the version 1 or 2, I believe. So after that, everything is like cucumber.api. We are using this latest 4. Of course, latest is 6 now, but still we are using this 4th version. Okay, so here the package name is cucumber.api. Okay, now within this, we have to specify some of the properties, right? So how do we define? Of course, we have to use this just let me. Okay, so first we have to use this dry run. Now, what do you mean by dry run? Any idea?
Yeah, dry run for like when you run the feature file, so it will run without any error.
No, it's not without any error. It will tell us like what are the steps has been implemented and what are the steps has not been implemented, right? So even this follows the same manual test cases as well. I mean manual testing as well. So when someone asks like just do the dry run, means what will you do?
Yeah.
We will just check all the functionalities at once.
We just check the like overall. We do not go in depth and we do not do like all the scenarios. We just do some random clicks and we are making sure that okay, some redirect is happening. That's it, right? So same thing dry run here also. What happens here is just I'm just going to execute and let me show you that. So when I click on run test ng test, here it says that some error we got. No feature file found, right? So even when I use this dry run, of course I'm asking this through dry run, but again the same problem, right? I have to say like where is my feature file and where is my step file. So for that we are going to use another keyword called glue here. So comma then followed by glue. So what is mean by glue?
To stick something.
Stick something, right? So that exactly. So here we have to use this curly braces. Of course it's going to accept arrays. So we are going to use this curly braces. And first we have to say where is our feature file, right? So here we have to give the feature file folder name, not the file name. Of course you can give the file name as well. Just we have only one file here, right? So I'm just going to give the feature file folder. So here feature, that's it. Don't give like SRC test Java feature or from the project or .../. Don't do anything. Just specify the folder name. That's enough. Cucumber has capability to understand from where is it has to take. Okay, so make sure that we have to give only this package name, nothing other than that. Because when we are setting the driver, what we used to do, driver dot, I mean system dot set property dot slash folder name slash driver dot exe, right? Don't do anything in the glue. Just give the package name. That's it. Then comma, then followed by, also we have to say where is our Java implementation. So Java implementation is within this guy, right? So step definition, right? So I'm just going to copy this file folder name and here I'm going to say. Okay, so that's it. Now let us try to run this. Okay, so no feature file found. What happened? Okay, just a second. I think here we have to give the SRC test Java slash feature. In the steps, we don't need to give anything. No? Okay, something wrong. Just a second. Okay, sorry. Here we have to say the feature first. So here it's going to be feature, and within this, we have to give the feature file. And in the glue, we have to only give the Java class, not this one. Sorry guys, I just messed up. And here we are going to say this, and let me try to run this now. Okay, so we got some exception. I will tell you what is the exception, but before that let us understand this this particular thing here. Sorry, I just messed up. Okay, so first we have to say where is our feature file. So we are saying that it is inside the SRC test folder, Java folder, and then followed by the package name. Now, just in case if I have multiple features, I can specify the feature file name as well. So here I can say again, slash login dot feature. So like this, I can save. Okay. And then within this glue, we have to say where is our actual test case. So our class file, but do not specify the class name or anything. Just specify like this. Package name alone. Now what should happen if we have multiple classes?
Yeah, Kaushik, so we are using here testng abstract. You added like abstract testng cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
Can you explain me like why we using this abstract testng cucumber?
Okay, so if I remove this now, So of course this is a class file, only a class file, right? So I do not have any options like run as we are getting this. That's because of this guy. So I'm just going to just let me try to run this. Let's see what happens. Okay. So here it says that no test found, right? Because of course we do not have any test. I mean, in the sense, we if you don't extend that class, we are not able to run this. But when I'm going to extend this, so this basically tells us how the Cucumber should run our test case. Okay, so abstract test ng test. Okay, so this class is basically coming from our this Cucumber API test ng library. So if you go to my pom.xml, here we can see we are using two libraries. One is the Cucumber Java and another one is this Cucumber test ng. We are using this two. So this dependency is actually going to help us to execute our feature file, whereas this Java package is going to help us to do the mapping. So when I say mapping, in the sense, whatever the steps we have written here, we are converting the steps in terms of Java file, right? So that's why we are using these annotations, and we are saying that each and every steps we have mapped this. Now when I'm going to run this, actually your Java class is not going to run, right? Because we do not have test ng, we do not have main method. Of course this class cannot be run, right? So to make sure that we are able to run this class from the feature file, we are not going to run the class file directly, we are going to run this feature file. Now technically this is your test case here, test script here. So this guy is going to trigger, but we know that this is not our Java file, right? This is a feature file. So how do we make sure that our feature file is able to run? Means we are going to use this particular class where it has already has some of the steps where it is going to map our Java file and the feature file together, and then it is going to run. Now in my project, I might have multiple step definition, multiple feature files, right? So here we have to specify what is your feature file and what is your class file.
So without test ng we can't run, like
no, we cannot
okay.
Kaushik, I just lost the internet issue connectivity. I just wanted to confirm, like, what exactly is glue and feature attributes?
So feature is like you're saying your actual feature file name. Okay, so where is your feature file? And this glue means we are sticking the code. So this whatever the code we have, whatever the steps we have written here, we have mapped that using this given at given annotation, right? So this is within this folder called step definition. So I'm just going to give that particular package name here. That's it.
So whatever package name we are giving, we need to give the exact package name in the glue attribute, and for the features I should give the exact path for the feature file.
Yes. Exact in the sense, don't give the whole package, just start from src test java. That is how,
so if it is in the same flow, then can we give just login.feature, or we need to give the exact file path, like from source itself?
I think from src test you only have to give, that is how the documentation specified. So here if you're going to run this, it says that not a file or directory. So basically it is not able to find it, because by default I said, like in the very beginning, like src test java is the default folder for this feature file, right? So of course we have to specify this. Okay, so why we are doing now is because of course we want to run our feature file, and also we want to get the code, right? So if I go and see here, you can see, right? So here we can see that it says one scenario runs where it has 8 steps, and we are getting some junk characters. We'll get rid of that, so don't worry. And here it says that you can implement the missing steps with the snippets below. That means it's already giving us this all the code, right? So here if I go to this particular Java file, here we can see we already have launched the browser and we have maximized the browser. After that, what we have this load the URL, right? So if I go to my console after the execution, here you can see it says that these are the steps is missing and you have to do the implementation. So it's giving like at given load the URL, at given set timeout, and when user enter the username, and we got almost all the steps here, right? So even if you have 150 steps or 100 steps, doesn't matter. You can use the dry run and it is going to give us all the snippets. Are you able to understand now why we are using this dry run?
Yes.
Okay. Now, if you notice carefully this method name, right? So it is going to give within this underscore, right? But are we going to use this underscore in our Java files?
No, special characters we don't mention in the method name.
Yes, we are going to use the camel case, right? Why this dry run is giving us in this format means, by default, Cucumber was designed for the Ruby programming language. Now, Ruby is similar to Python, where they follow this snake cases. So this underscore things they follow, right? So that is why by default, it is going to give us in the underscore. But of course, we can change that using the snippet here. So here I can say snippets. And here I can say snippets, come on. Snippets type dot. Here you can see we have this camel case and underscore. So we are going to use the camel case now. By default, it will be underscore, but we are going to use the camel case. Okay. Now,
what
if I try.
What is the difference, Kaushik, what is the difference between underscore and camel case?
Underscore means here we will get this underscore.
And what is this camel? Like here we are taking camel case.
So once we give this camel case and if I try to execute now, here you can see all the methods has been changed to camel case.
Okay.
So
in whatever format we want to change, we will give that command.
Yes, only two formats are there. No, what not whatever. So only camel case or the underscore. Okay. Now I'm going to copy the entire code base here. And I'm going to copy and I'm going to paste in my feature file. I mean in my class file. So that's it. Very easy, right? But if you noticed here, we are using this load the URL using the keyword called and, right? But when the test case has been generated, when the dry run has executed and we got the snippets, if you see here, everywhere it's giving us given, not and, okay? Technically, what happens is the keyword given and doesn't matter in terms of programming, in terms of Java. This annotation just going to check if we have mapped or not. So you can use given and when anywhere within the class file. That's not a problem at all when we are going to execute. But these are just for our understanding. Okay. Now here we can see that this when is not coming. Of course, we have to do the import. And then is also not coming. We have to do the import. Now we are almost done with our methods. But of course, we should not use this keyword, right? So here you can see throw new cucumber. API dot pending exception. That means we have to implement this. So I'm just going to copy and replace everything without anything. Not coming. Okay, so let me just delete this. Okay, so make sure before executing, you are going to delete this or else we will end up with exception. Okay. Are you able to understand so far what we have done?
Yes, Kaushik. One extension also available in Google. Like when you paste your feature file and click on run, so automatically it will create a
even in this natural editor also we have. So if I see here, it says that run as feature file, that is there. Don't use that. I will not recommend because it gives us so many errors and bugs. Sometimes it just misconfigured and it takes some different test cases. So don't use the any of the feature file runner. Create your own runner file and run from there. Okay. Now, if you notice, we have mapped all our steps, but if I go to this feature file, still we are getting the says that no definition found for load the URL. So what we have to do now?
We will implement.
No, just edit the file and save. Yeah. That's it. Okay. Oh. So it's, it doesn't do the auto compilation. So we have to just edit and save. So it will do the compilation. Okay. Now, if you see here, if I go to this right click and do open declaration, it is going to take me to that particular step. Okay, so that is why we are using this plugin. So if I go and do right click and here, you can see we are able to get this. So here I'm just quickly going to write the test case. So just this out statement, login success. Okay, so I think I have already the test case. So let me just copy and paste. I think we have written so many test cases. Huh? So copy here and paste somewhere and this guy should cut. And here it should be username. And and here it should be enter the password, and here it should be become the login. And of course, we are doing not checking anything. We are just writing the sys out here. Okay, so we are almost done. See, okay, I have to remove this guy. Set timeout. So driver dot manage, not this one. So manage dot timeouts dot implicitly wait 20 seconds, and that's it. Okay, so we are done with the implementation. We are done with the feature file. Now let's see how to run this. So if I'm going to right click and run as test ng test, of course it should run now. Let's see. We are getting some error again. What happened? Okay, here we are able to see that the skip scenario is skipped, right? So just let me increase the font size again, and if I try to run this now, here we can see we are not getting any exceptions, like we have to do the mapping, but it says that skipped exception. So remember this exception, org.stng.skip exception. When we will get the skip exception,
when there is some sort of dependency due to which the dependency didn't execute and this step got skipped.
Yes, so that is in terms of test ng. Here, why we are getting exception, skip exception, means we are saying that dry run equal to true. So dry run is actually not going to execute your code. It is just going to check whether we have implemented all the steps from our feature file. So here we can simply just make this as false. So that's it. So once if I try to run this now after making it false, so now here you can see, so it's launched my browser, and then it should maximize load, enter username, password, and that's it. Okay. It's running. Did we give the URL? No. We didn't
know.
Okay. So that is the problem. We didn't give the URL actually. So where is the URL? It will be in the base class, right? So let me copy and paste. Okay. So I'm just going to close all others to the left. Okay. So I'm just going to close this browser and run again. It failed because I didn't give the driver.get URL, so that's a problem, nothing else. So they run. Okay, so control F11 and it should run now. Let's see what happens. So it's launched and dun, and signed in, and that's it, right? So anyway, it's going to run, so that's not a problem. It's actually loading, so let's wait until the load's completed. It's done, and here we can see our test case has been passed, right? So here we can see that, let me maximize this. Here you can see that it says that passed run scenario. What scenario it ran is, it's run the login positive and from the feature of AUT Mercury, okay? Please remember, first it will give you the scenario name and then followed by the feature name, okay? And then it also giving us some of the time, like it took around 24 seconds, I believe, right? And after that, we are able to get some characters here. Are you able to read this? What are those? Okay, so basically these guys are nothing but junk characters. So we are going to get rid of that using the keyword called monochrome. So monochrome equal to true. Okay, so if I run this now, let me add the driver.quit as well. So I go to the last step. Come on, I can open this. So here I'm just going to say driver.quit. Not this one. Okay, so now I'm going to this file and right click and run as test ng test. Don't worry, I will give you a break now. So just the execution.
So we have two ways, like we can run by test ng and we can run by junit, right?
Yes, junit also possible. So junit doesn't have that much feature comparing to test ng. So This website is slow or my internet? We are getting some dot dot dot. This means that the number of methods has been passed. So that is why we are getting this dot dot dot. Sometimes we will get as F. That means so any of the step has been failed. Okay. So it's taking more time. Okay. If I close this, will I get the output? No, I think. Okay, so we got this. I closed it manually, so not a problem. So here we can see login success. So this is basically our sysout statement. And here we can see one scenario passed. And I mean, the number of scenarios we have is one, and number of steps we have is 8. And in that, of course, one scenario has passed and 8 steps has also passed. And it says that 1:15 it took to execute the code, right? So now we are able to get rid of the junk characters using this monochrome, right? Now, what if I want to check for Firefox?
Koushik, that to get rid of the junk characters, we are using that monochrome. But what is that attribute actually doing internally? Means to
internally, that's going to remove the junk characters, because I said that Cucumber is designed for the Ruby. So in Ruby, they have some specific characters which doesn't support in the Java. So okay. For that, that's basically converts into junk characters, right? For example, when you load some Tamil website, if your system doesn't have Tamil fonts, it's going to give us in the square boxes, right? So same thing happens here as well. So we are just using this monochrome. So if there is some any junk characters, it is going to get rid of that.
Got it.
Okay, so it, don't go with a name. It is not like Firefox, Mono, Internet, something like that.
Just exactly, the name is confusing.
Yeah, so monochrome means it's just like how we, the black and white something is known as monochrome, right? So same
monochrome
thing.
Monochrome and, yes.
Yeah, so same thing. Okay, so that's it, guys. I'm just going to give you a break. I know this too much.